Hello there, this is Tejas from Trendlyne, and in this video, we look at the growth prospects of the Indian economy, which is facing multiple headwinds. We'll examine the latest GDP data, RBI's monetary policy meeting that ended on December 7th, and other factors affecting GDP growth, both positive and negative. The Nifty 50 has been hitting life highs in the past month as investors are optimistic about India's growth amid a slowing global economy. Investors are also happy about inflation cooling in October domestically and globally. However, the question is, how fast can the Indian economy grow, especially while fighting a weak global outlook and elevated inflation? Unlike Q1 FY23, when the print came in lower than expected, India's GDP growth in Q2 was in line with analysts' estimates. However, the growth rate was considerably lower than Q1 as the COVID base normalized. Gross value added, or GVA, rose 5.6% year-on-year, driven by faster than expected growth in the farm and services sector. GVA gives the rupee value of goods and services produced in the economy after deducting the cost of inputs and raw materials used. Even though real GDP growth fell in Q2 compared to Q1, it grew 7.6% compared to the corresponding quarter pre-COVID. In Q1, this number was at 3.8%. The Indian economy is indeed surpassing the pre-COVID times, but we now have different challenges to factor in while assessing growth projections. Post the Q2 FY23 GDP data release, several rating agencies like Moody's and CRISIL revised their annual growth projections downwards. The Reserve Bank of India lowered its FY23 GDP growth forecast by 200 basis points to 6.8%. S&P also cut the projection from 7% to 7.3%. Only the World Bank raised its projections, citing the Indian economy's higher resilience to global shocks. But most agencies lowered forecasts due to slowing global economic growth, especially in the Europe and in the US, which is expected to impact India. The energy situation in Europe also weighed down sentiment. Before we move on to the factors affecting the GDP growth, let's have a look at what helped in Q2. Private and government consumption was the key contributor, but net exports continued to drag the GDP and trade deficit as the trade deficit widened. Another interesting bit here is that discrepancies stood at a 10 quarter high in Q2, which suggests that substantial revisions in sectoral growth numbers may lie ahead. Government and private consumption contributed 5.1 percentage points to the GDP growth in Q2, but a closer examination of data shows that private consumption growth was the sole driver in this segment, as government spending fell 4.4% year-on-year against a 9.7% growth in the private consumption. As a result, 18 states are set to miss the capex targets for FY23 due to weak growth in H1. Though private consumption grew year-on-year, the rate is lower on both year-on-year and quarter-on-quarter. In addition, the value of new projects announced in Q2 fell for the second consecutive quarter. Going forward, it could be a worrying sign as the sector contributes heavily to GDP growth with other factors like net exports on a downtrend. Speaking of net exports, India's trade deficit widened to 14.6 billion in October 2022, the highest since June 2020. A significant reason for this was the 16.7% year-on-year fall in merchandise exports, the first such decline in exports in 19 months. Demand fell across the EU and the US markets, while the festive season in India slowed the domestic production. As per the latest data, electronic goods was the only major sector that saw a rise in exports in October. The engineering goods sector, which contributed nearly 25% of the total merchandise, fell 21.3% year-on-year. Exports of handloom products and gems and jewelry also fell due to a weak global demand. With a gloomy global outlook, exports could further come under pressure. In addition to falling exports in the merchandise sector, one factor that surprised both investors and the analysts was the manufacturing sector contracting 4.3% in Q2. While the mining and quarrying sector fell in Q2, the electricity and construction sector grew. The manufacturing sector fell despite private consumption rising in Q2. One possible reason for this could be that private consumption growth was mainly driven by import growth. So a pickup in the manufacturing sector will be very important going forward. One trend that bodes well for India is the rising foreign institutional and portfolio investments over the past 2 months. FPIs turned net positive in November with an investment of around $4 billion. This inflow, coupled with the cooling of inflation in October, led to investors having a positive outlook on the Indian market, which hit an all-time high in the past month. However, this can change very quickly if foreign investors panic over any worrisome economic data. Post the bi-monthly Monetary Policy Committee meeting, which ended on December 7th, the Reserve Bank of India raised rates by an expected 35 basis points, taking the repo rate to 6.25%. In 2022, the RBI raised rates by 2.25 percentage points and is expected to raise another 35 BPS in its next meeting. This will take the final rate to 6.6% in February. But if the inflation rate rises again, especially with the aggravating energy problems in Europe, we could be in for more rate hikes. This, in turn, could hurt domestic demand and consumption, leading to slower economic growth. In fact, RBI governor was hawkish in his comments after the meeting on December 7th. Das said that the main risk was inflation remaining sticky and elevated, leading to core inflation persistent and its second round effects. As a result, RBI downgraded the FY23 GDP growth to 6.8% after this meeting. The RBI continues to maintain a hawkish tone in its commentary because inflation has been over its upper tolerance limit of 6% for three consecutive quarters. Moreover, RBI maintained its inflation forecast of 6.8% in FY23, still above the limit. The RBI governor believes that the Indian economy remains resilient and expects to be the fastest growing in Asia in FY23. With all these moving factors, India's economic growth is likely to be under pressure, especially if inflation doesn't subside, leading to more rate hikes. With weak global demand hurting economic growth, exports are being hit. Private consumption was the main factor that drove growth in Q2. Pickup in government and private consumption is a prerequisite for strong economic growth in FY23. Robust domestic demand will also be key. There might be more surprises ahead. External factors like price capping on Urals crude oil could exacerbate the elevated inflation to hurt economic growth. On the other hand, an inflation cooldown in India could lead to a stronger domestic demand and a better outlook. But several downside risks outnumber the upsides in FY23. So in this video, we looked into various macroeconomic factors that could affect the Indian economy. You can find more information about different sectors and industries on trendlyne.com. This is Tejas, signing off.